front door slams horrendously, and while we're taping, it's very distracting. So we're going to hope that we don't get too many late arrivals, but I will call the meeting to order now. Welcome to the January 8th meeting of CONA, which is the Sarasota County Council of Neighborhood Associations. So I lived here for at least a year before anyone finally explained to me what the abbreviation stood for. So once I found out, I joined. Tonight's topic is the structuring and funding of public-private partnerships. And in this case, this evening, we're going to be focusing on the Benderson Rowan Park. We have some very specific guests here that can speak educatedly about how that end of things came to be. Many of our meetings are available on videos on our website. So if you visit the conasarasota.org website and check the meetings page, you'll see archives of our past meetings, and most, not all, will have an attached video if you're interested in this topic. And there are many very interesting topics. So, also, there are resource materials on the site. Same thing, if you hunt around on the site a little bit, you'll find a host of things that would be interesting and useful. That brings us to our announcements. Oh, I'm going to get in so much trouble for not using this microphone.
Does everybody know who you are?
I should introduce myself. I think I missed that part of the agenda. I'm Melanie Goddard, and I am a board member of CONA at this point. So I am also the president of the Gulf Gate Community Association. So any of you that are familiar with Gulf Gate on the southern side, kind of near where, on a whole different project, Siesta Promenade is supposed to be. So that is me, and enough about that. Let's move on to our announcements, and there are none from our end. Are there others from the floor that might have any to make? Nope. All right then. And I would like to welcome Sir Kochman. Who is, you are president of Pine Shores?
No, a representative.
Representative of the Pine Shores Community Association.
Neighborhood Alliance.
We all do a lot of the same things. It's just semantics. So, and my understanding is that you wanted to have a moment to bring us up to date. At least Kathy said to give you that opportunity, so.
Okay.
And I'm referring to Kathy Benz, who is our president here of Sarasota CONA, County CONA. And she will be joining us in a short while, but in the meantime.
Okay. This will be off the cuff since I wasn't prepared to do this. Benderson has filed their responses to the county. Their responses are in relation to the county's finding of their applications being insufficient and incomplete. This finding was made last July, and they just filed their responses on December 28th. You can find it on the website, Sarasota County, under the rezones. It has two special little sections. It's not under the Siesta Promenade application. It just says third response to Siesta Promenade, and then third response for the transportation for Siesta Promenade. The responses have been underwhelming and disappointing. They've added 5 access points to move traffic from the proposed project through our neighborhood. Somehow Kimley Horn has determined that by adding 414 apartments and 140,000 square feet of retail and 130-room hotel, traffic will be improved at the Stickney Point 41 intersection. They are indicating that a constitution now be reclassified as a more major roadway. The name, the actual terminology escapes me because I don't have notes with me. But it is an underwhelming response at best. And most disappointing is that when Kim Ling Horn, who is supposed to be a professional organization, submitted their information to the county, they mentioned that all responses had been given to FDOT and county transportation staff. Unfortunately, they omitted a letter that came from FDOT to them prior to the filing by Benderson, indicating that they had not met their signal warrants, they had indicated what was going to happen with Avenue A, and a host of other items that really needed some further attention. So we're keeping our eyes and ears open on this. We don't know what the county is going to do as far as determining whether this new batch of information will deem the application complete. We will not know that for approximately 3 to 4 weeks from now.
All right, thank you, Sarah. I should note that the next home meeting is February 12th, and that meeting will continue on the topic of Siesta Promenade, and hopefully will be an update should you have more information at that time to flesh this out. So definitely a topic of interest, and so keep posted. We will, and you should be receiving these notices either through your association, administration, or if you're on our email list. And if you're not receiving them, please check our website. We do have a calendar, and you can be kept up to date, probably even sign up for emails on the website as well. So that brings us to our program of the evening. And the program itself is a panel discussion with CONA members, Pat Rounds and Mr. Bill Zoller, and our guests, Stephen Rodriguez and Frederick Piccolo. Unfortunately, Dennis Malley was unable to join us. The poor gentleman has a terrible flu, and from all descriptions, it's probably just as well he's not joining us this evening. So, but we do miss him, and we do have some printed material that would represent his contribution for the evening. So, that being said, I would like to have the panel introduce themselves, and then the program may begin. So, Pat, would you start?
Yeah, my name is Pat Rounds. I'm a 13-year resident of Sarasota, Florida. Yes.
My name is Pat Rounds. I've lived here now for 13 years. I retired in 2005. I love Florida, virtually every aspect of Sarasota County, West Coast, the whole state of Florida is fantastic. And I've become somewhat active in community civic activities, and I am currently a board member of CONA.
I'm Bill Zoller. That should be on back there.
No, I'm not hearing it.
Ah.
There we go. I didn't have the button pushed hard enough. I'm a Florida native, one of those rare birds that you can go out to the celery fields and see me out there sometime, probably. But, my great-grandparents settled this area in the 1800s, along with some others, of course. And I've been here in Sarasota since 71, when we came back to the area after school and what have you. And I'm a past president of CONA, and I'm on the board, and just concerned about always the future of this beautiful county.
Thank you. I'm Stephen Rodriguez. I'm with Sanka at Nathan Benderson Park, and I'm another one of those rare birds. I am a native Floridian, born down in Miami, and I call Gainesville my home of the Fighting Gators. But I've been down here in Sarasota since August, so I'm excited about being part of the community.
Stephen, could you give the title for Sanka?
I'm the president and CEO for Sanka.
I misspoke.
What does Sanka mean?
Yeah, Suncoast Aquatic Nature Center Associates.
Good evening, I'm Rick Piccolo. I serve as president and CEO of the airport, but also serve on a number of boards in the community that are charitable as well as educational. And one of those boards that I serve on is the Nathan Benderson Park Foundation. I've been a resident here about 21 years in Sarasota, in Florida about 35 years, but originally from New York State. So I'm a transplant like many of us in this room. So look forward to the discussion.
All right, thank you for the introductions, and I'm going to turn the mic over to Ms. Rounds, who will be beginning the program.
Thank you, and just wanted to acknowledge you all coming out tonight. It's a very important topic, but the competition is at home watching the college football championships. So we should be able to see some of it if you're interested, but thank you for coming out tonight. And so the format will be informal, but Bill and I have put together a slide presentation. We're going to present a citizen's perspective on the park, watching it grow from, well, I wasn't here when it was a borrow pit, okay, but over the last 5 or 6 years, a lot of things have changed at the rowing park, and we're going to give our vantage point, what we've seen, questions that we have, and then we'll turn things over to Stephen and Rick, and they can provide their perspective on this and tell us what's going to be happening in the future. After which, we have a Q&A, so if you all have any questions of any of us, you know, please feel free to speak up. First thing, we probably all agree that public parks and recreation areas are very valuable assets for our community. That's a given, okay? We need them, we thrive on them. This area is gorgeous. We need to make the best of all the natural assets that we have here. So that's a given, including rowing parks. I live probably maybe a mile and a half away from the rowing park and spent a lot of time walking dogs around the perimeter of the rowing park. And I was just there yesterday. A lot of people out enjoying themselves. Some rowers practicing, but there were people on bikes, people walking, etc. So we all agree that parks and recreation areas are valuable for our community. 6 years ago or so, and what I've done, and can you all see this well enough? And I'll read through it quickly, but I want to provide third-party support. So all the slides that you see are coming from official documents, okay? Back in 2011, Herald Tribune ran an article talking about how the rowing park had evolved from a $3 million plan for a few competitive rowing events at a county-owned lake. But Benderson Development saw a much larger vision for it, okay? So Benderson Development convinced county commissioners and business leaders to go along and make this a grand place. So as of 2011, the cost for the rowing course and other improvements would grow to $40 million from $3 million, 19 of which was provided by Sarasota County through a tourist tax bond. And at the time, Commissioner Thaxton, and this is an article that quotes comments from a commission meeting, he said he understood they had a lot at stake as well as the county. They have had this commitment to Sarasota. They've got their name all over the thing. Just to give you kind of a chronology, 2011-2012. As I said, the county provided $19.5 million through a no-bid contract to create, because we want to go large, we want to make the rowing park a world-class venue, to create a man-made, what's called Regatta Island, okay? And everybody's been there, right? To the rowing park, okay? So before, there was no island. That had to be made. Dredging and creating this man-made island in order to help qualify for these much larger rowing events the course needed to be lengthened too, to a certain size too, to be eligible for large rowing events. So the county provided 20 million bucks to create this man-made island and a lot of other infrastructure. The state as well provided at this time $10 million. $10 million, so the total was about roughly $30 million to create the infrastructure for the park. And then in 2013, it was decided that, well, you know, this is really growing, we're gonna make this great, let's go for the gusto. Let's put in a bid to host the 2017 World Rowing Championships. And of course, we know they won that bid, right? Since then, 2016, hosted the World Cup. A lot of events take place at Benderson Rowing Park. Rowing events, other kinds of events, water events, other sorts of contests and events as well. So 2016 featured the World Cup.
Not rowing. The World Rowing Championship.
Right. 2017, we had the World Rowing Championships last September. And in next year, lots of other good things are on the schedule as well, and including the World Masters Regatta. So we're transforming a former borrow pit into a premier rowing facility through a public-private partnership. And one outstanding question that we have is with this a truly binding commitment of all parties, from all parties, or an informal understanding that everyone would contribute their share to creating a world-class venue? In total, when you add up all the numbers to date, if this park is actually completed fully, it will cost about $60 million. Some 40 plus million public funding, 22 million private funding. Now let's talk about the vision versus the reality. So in 2013, Sarasota, Manatee Counties, and Sanka decided we're gonna go for it, we're gonna put in a bid to host the World Rowing Championship 4 years from now, 2017. This is the venue, Plovdiv, Bulgaria, that was the competition to Sarasota, to Benderson Rowing Park. At the time, Plovdiv already looked like this. It was already an international European rowing facility with permanent grandstands, boathouse, finish tower. So, in order to get selected over Plovdiv, Sarasota was going to have to show something great. And, which is what they did. This slide, it's a little difficult to see. I tried my best to make it as big as I possibly could. But this is pulled from the bid presentation that was delivered to the site selection committee for the 2017 World Rowing Championships. And this is a rendering of what the park would look like for the World Rowing Championships and the approximate costs of each of these elements. And on the top it says Nathan Benderson Park Capital Improvement Plan, improvements to be completed March 2016 for the World Cup that year. Okay? So we have a boathouse there, the rendering says $10 million price tag, the finishing tower, $2.2 million. We've got multi-millions of dollars to make this a world-class place. Multi-million dollar investment. This is what was presented to the site selection committee to convince them to choose Sarasota over Plovdiv, Bulgaria. Here's another rendering that's a little more clear. I don't think this was in the bid presentation, but this shows you down in the bottom left, that would be the boathouse. Okay, and there's the rowing course. To the left of that, there's permanent grandstands. There's the finishing tower. It's a pretty grand looking facility. Wonderful vision. When Sarasota was selected, there was a county press release, September 2nd, 2013, all about the great job that we did convincing the site selection committee to pick us over Bulgaria. That bulletin, that press release, indicated the commitment by Sarasota and Manatee counties, Sanka, and the support of the U.S. Rowing convinced FISA's World Congress that returning to the United States for the World Rowing Championship was the correct vote. Okay, so now we have a public-private partnership, okay? Who pays for what? Same county press release, back in 2013, some $30 million had been pledged, combining county money, $20 million, and $10 million from the state. They were going, that $30 million was going to create phases one and two of the construction, which essentially was infrastructure. Dredge and fill to create the man-made Regatta Island, park amenities, hardscaping, landscaping. Then, phase three of the project, which was going to be a state-of-the-art boathouse, finish tower, grandstands, other amenities, that would be paid for, funded by Sanka and corporate support. Sounds good. Within 6 months of that, Sanka was already going back to the state for more public funding. This is from the Herald Tribune, April 2014. Rowing boosters are pushing to finish the construction of the complex before hosting the World Rowing Championships, a feat that will require roughly $22 million in additional spending. To accomplish that goal, Sanka has hired a lobbyist to request $11 million from the state budget this year. That got turned down. Okay? You see the slide before. Phase three, the completion of the park, all the buildings, they were going to be funded by Sanka and corporate support. So we're going to the state within 6 months of stating that. The following year, they tried again. It was going to be a matching funding agreement. Sanka would provide, and Benderson Foundation at this point, because Benderson Foundation, I believe, had taken over fundraising from Sanka, would provide $11 million towards that $22 million goal, and then the state would provide the other $11 million. However, just a month from the deadline to meet that goal, Sanka was $6 million, or Foundation was $6 million short of their goal. So that was also turned down. No lack of trying here, okay? August of that year, several individuals have specifically focused on fundraising for these phase three structures, including a gentleman who was on loan from the community, Gulf Coast Community Foundation. Because, you know, you have the World Rowing Championships looming just 2 years from this time, okay? And you really do need to raise that money quickly, all right, in order to achieve your goal. So all of these things were intended to be finished for the World Rowing Championships, funded now with from the private sector. From the same Observer article, you can see here specifically at that time, the organization, the foundation, had raised $5.3 million of the $22 million goal. And you can see the approximate costs here for the finished tower, boathouse, grandstands, etc. Totals up to $22 million. So you're about one quarter of the way there, okay? With 2 years to go before your major event. So as of, you know, based on my research and this is everything that I've been able to get from public sources, from the internet, from public records requests, because the county and Sanka are supposed to comply with state law FS-119, which is Public Records Open Meetings Law. Some things I've been able to get, some things I have not. I've had outstanding questions about the status of private funding for going on 2 years. But from what I can gather, the public contribution, and this is state, county, contributions have totaled some $43.5 million.
Can you break that $43 million down, the sources of it?
I'm sorry, what?
Can you break that public source down?
Yeah, okay. The county for infrastructure is about $20 million. The state, about $10 million for infrastructure. The state has, since the Regatta Island was built in 2016, gave $2.5 million. And then in 2017, another $2.5 million. So that's a total of $15 million from the state and $20 million from the county. But in addition to that, Manatee and Sarasota County pledged about $5.6 million to help host the event itself. Not to build anything, really, but to make sure the event went off without a hitch. It was a $5.6 million commitment between the counties. And then Sanka has required support